Brad, we touched upon Saquon Barkley, who most people would consider the Heisman favorite right now, had the big game against Michigan, had a titanic game early in the season against a tough Iowa defense on the road, in which if he wasn't on the field, Penn State doesn't win that game. Certainly, last week was just kind of window dressing because Penn State had it all over Michigan. But if he can run against this defense and put up big numbers, then that's not only necessarily going to win the Big Ten eventually for Penn State, but win him a Heisman.
No, I think you're right. If he goes 185, a couple touchdowns, and Penn State wins at Ohio State, you know, we can pretty much lock up a Heisman unless something goes disastrously wrong, you know, down the stretch. Bryce Love's probably the number two right now. You saw last night, Mark, Stanford barely won on the road at Oregon State without Bryce Love. That just shows his importance right there to a team that really needs him to rush for 250 if they're going to win. Stanford improved to 6-2. Probably number three right now would be Baker Mayfield. He's putting up, you know, video game numbers once again at Oklahoma, his third year as a starter. And then, you know, full range, there's a few guys, but JT Barrett, I think right now, based on what he's done the last month of the season, he's kind of solidified the number four spot. And he could probably jump in to that top two range if Ohio State limits Saquon Barkley, and then he has a 3 or 4 touchdown game Saturday.
Yeah, JT Barrett has to be one of the more successful, much maligned quarterbacks in college football history, really, when you look at what he's accomplished in his track record. But because of him delivering early in his career, the expectations being so high at Ohio State, period, but especially with him in play, the disappointments in the big games in recent times for Ohio State, we'll see what JT has on Saturday. And of course, he's going to need the help of the offensive line and the wide receivers to separate against big opponents, something that's cost the Buckeyes in recent big game matchups. Luke Falk's out there. The three-point effort against Cal has certainly hurt his stock. Sam Darnold's out of the race. Yeah. Baker Mayfield, I would think, would still be in play as well, putting up big game stats. And if he gets college football of Oklahoma to the Big 12 championship and a college football playoff appearance, maybe he gets in play. Too much sharing of the ball at Georgia with their three big running backs. Is there anybody out there that maybe we don't consider right now, but that has a couple big stage matchups late in the season that could sneak in the back door?
Yeah, I think Alabama quarterback Jalen Hurts is kind of a dark horse pick. He was a guy that I put a little money on in the preseason because his odds were so low, knowing that Alabama would likely be 12-0 in November, and he'd be a big part of it. Right now, Mark, I think he's 21-1 as a starter. Really doesn't get talked about because Bama does not have to throw the ball downfield too much to win ball games. But, you know, he's putting together another solid season. You know, you look at some of the analytics, and he's having a better season as a sophomore than he is as a freshman. The numbers don't jump off the page, but obviously he's a leader for that offense. Alabama has some big games coming up against LSU, Mississippi State, Auburn, likely Georgia and Atlanta. So that's four chances right there for Hurts to really show what he's got if that Alabama run game is contained. But as every season, you know, thus far, no one can stop Bama at the line of scrimmage, and that's where Bama really feasts.